4 sticks of butter in the air fryer. You're gonna start with 2.5 cups of flour. And this is the best way to sift your flour without making a mess. This is just all-purpose flour.
Just regular all-purpose flour, mm-hmm. Okay.
And using this method keeps everything inside the bowl, no mess. We're gonna add 1 teaspoon of salt, 4 tablespoons of baking powder, and 3 tablespoons of granulated sugar. Whisk those dry ingredients together. To that, we're gonna add 2 cups of buttermilk. And this should be buttermilk, not regular milk. And then we're gonna blend that together. All right, we've got our melted butter and our batter is ready. And you're actually just gonna spoon this right on top of the melted butter. Be careful not to let it splatter. Of course, you don't have to melt the butter in the air fryer. You could melt the butter in the microwave and then just pour it over the top as well. That would also work. Now you're just gonna spread your batter out. And these are called butter swim biscuits for obvious reasons. We're gonna spread that batter out, making sure that it fills most of our pan. And then you're gonna take a knife and you're just gonna kind of slice it through. And I know this looks a little weird, but y'all just gotta trust the process, all right? This is gonna be good. Stick with me, all right? You slice it through just like that. You can go back a second time, just so they're separated. All right, then that goes back into your air fryer. And this time, we've got our air fryer set to 325. We're gonna go about 15 minutes. And then our biscuit's gonna be ready. But now I'm making some chocolate gravy. This is something y'all have been requesting and it is delicious. For our chocolate gravy, we're gonna start with 1/3 of a cup of unsweetened cocoa powder. 3 tablespoons of all-purpose flour. 1 cup of granulated sugar. 1 pinch of salt, and now we need some milk. Would you grab the milk, please? It's in the fridge on the top shelf.
Sure, I can get that for you.
Thank you.
There it is. Here you go.
Perfect. And we're gonna pour in our milk. It's 1.5 cups, and you're gonna start whisking everything together. Be prepared to whisk a lot with this one. I've got it on medium heat. Now you wanna actually stir this continuously for 5 to 7 minutes. There's gonna be a bit at the beginning where you're like, this is not thickening up. Well, just be patient, keep going. It'll start to thicken, it'll start to bubble, and that is what you want. We've got just a couple more ingredients to add, and then we're gonna take those biscuits out of our air fryer, and we're gonna drizzle this over the top of our biscuits and taste test, and it's gonna be delicious. All right, it's bubbling, so now it's time to add our other ingredients. You're gonna mix in about 3 tablespoons of melted butter and 1 teaspoon of vanilla extract. So that was vanilla extract. We're just gonna whisk that in and then it's gonna be time to taste test. So if it's all right with y'all, we're gonna have a little bit of story time because this recipe, both of these specifically, are actually close to my heart. The biscuits, the butter swim biscuits, are a kind of biscuit that my mom would make. And the chocolate gravy is something that my dad would make. Now, I was super close to my dad. I was daddy's girl, if there ever was one. He was my best friend. We lost him about 7 years ago to cancer, and it's been really difficult for me. And I've actually postponed making this recipe because I wanted to do it justice. I didn't want to mess it up. So I'm really excited to try this. I would love to hear from you. Let me know, what are the special recipes from your family that you like to make now to get wonderful memories from them? Because this is one that reminds me of my dad. All right, our biscuits are ready. Let's take a look and see how they did in the air fryer. Oh, look at that. This is gonna be so good. And you see how we just had those little lines? That allows us to cut a slice. Look at that. fluffy, delicious biscuits. Let me place this on my bowl. Remember that chocolate gravy? We've got that ready to pour over the top. Now, the consistency you want is about like this. It's a little bit runny.
Oh my.
Doesn't that look heavenly? I'm nervous. This better live up to my mom and dad's version. It probably won't, but I'm so excited to try it. Kyle's had these before, so he will be a good judge as well. You ready to taste test this?
Absolutely.
I have been waiting to make these for so long. All right. I'm gonna give you the first bite.
This is exciting.
Now, the chocolate biscuits and gravy are a Southern tradition. All right, let's see how we did.
All right, cheers. Cheers. This is good.
I did really good.
This is good.
And I know it looks like a lot of butter at the beginning. You can cut down on the butter if you want. You don't end up eating all the butter. No.
This is so good and so healthy too.
No. This is not healthy. This is the opposite of healthy. You could make some swaps. You could use, you know, stevia instead of the sugar if you want. But this is not, this is a feel-good home-cooked meal. This is not diet food. Now, did I do as good as my dad and my mom? I don't know if I got that. This is not bad for my first try, but I definitely think that you're gonna love this one. Mm-hmm. So give it a try. Chocolate gravy and butter swim biscuits.
So good.